Hi, this is Karen McKee, the scientist videographer. Would you like to make a video about your science topic, but don't have time to plan, shoot, and edit a movie from scratch? Today I'm going to show you how to use an option in iMovie to create a movie-style trailer like the one you just saw. Hollywood uses movie trailers, which most people are familiar with, to announce upcoming movies. You can use the same approach to promote a new paper or research project, or to announce a recent discovery or a novel method. Students might use this approach to create a video about a field trip or for a conference poster. It's a fun way to generate interest in your work and let others know what you are doing. I'm going to be using the desktop version of iMovie, but you can also use the iMovie app on an iPhone or an iPad. In iMovie, click the plus sign to create a new project, then select the movie trailer option. Now you see several options. Step one is to select from this list of templates. These templates have different themes, pacing, and music. What I'm going to do is recreate my movie trailer, which was based on the adrenaline theme. Once selected, click Create Trailer. Now what we need to do is title our movie trailer. And this one I'm going to entitle Mangroves in Peril 2 to distinguish it from the original. And you also want to select the event that you want your trailer to go into, and I'm going to select this one. Select OK. Now you will see a screen with several panels. On the far left are your media libraries, and I've selected the event containing the media for this project, which can be seen in the adjacent panel. I can scroll through these clips to find what I want. To the right is the viewer window where you can review the movie project as you progress. At the bottom is the trailer editor, which shows three tabs: the trailer outline, the storyboard, and the shot list. We'll take a look at each of these as we build the trailer. Next is we want to customize the text. Starting with the outline, I can name my movie and add other information. The last section is going to appear as a group of credits at the end of the trailer. By default, it uses your name for all the credits. You may want this in your trailer, but if not, I'll show you how to remove it later. So here I've added the name of my hypothetical paper where it says movie name, so Mangroves in Peril. For a studio, you can put your institution or the name of your laboratory or research group. I've already added the scientist videographer. The next line allows you to switch out the logo style. So I've selected Galaxy, but you have a number of other options. For example, Spinning Earth in Space. Or if you prefer a plain black background. But I'll go back to Galaxy, which is what I used in the original movie trailer. The next step is to use the storyboard to set up the sequence of video clips and text to appear in your trailer. For this, you want to select the storyboard view. What you now see are placeholders for your media with suggested scenes such as a group scene, a wide shot, or a medium shot. In between are lines of placeholder text that you will modify to fit your message. Let's play a bit by tapping the play button at the bottom right of the viewer. Okay, so you get the idea of how this is going to work, even with the placeholders. Now, I suggest starting with the text and change all the lines to say what you want to appear in your movie trailer. The template templates restrict you to only a few words that will appear, so you are forced to stick to a really simple short message. In this case, I'm going to create a trailer to announce a hypothetical paper that is going to be published soon. With the first line, you want to capture the viewer's attention. Just click inside the text box and retype. I'm going to change this line to read, "They travel to remote shores." To one of the most threatened ecosystems in the world. To figure out how mangrove islands survive sea level rise. And you can see that as you're typing, you can see what is being typed in the viewer panel up here. With these few words, I've explained that our research focus was on mangroves occurring along remote shorelines, and our objective was to find out how mangrove islands survive rising sea level. Next is the purpose of the trailer, which is to announce a new paper about this research, which will be available in August. And I'll end with the title of the paper, which is Mangroves in Peril. Now, as I said, this is a hypothetical title, so all you mangrove fans out there, this is not a real paper. I just made it up for this tutorial. Okay, this tutorial is running a bit long, so I'm going to split it into two parts. In part two, we will begin adding video clips to the trailer.